to the Word of God. But then, preparation. 1 Peter 2, verses 1 and 2. Wherefore, laying aside all malice, and all guile, and hypocrisies, and envies, and all evil speakings, as newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the Word, that ye may grow thereby. And the preparation here is putting aside all these things. Malice, guile, hypocrisy, envy, evil speaking. In other words, we cannot come to the Word of God truly prepared if we have all these things in our hearts and minds. We must remove all these and come to the Word of God like those spiritual babies, hungry, desiring the pure and sincere milk of the Word so that we might grow. And then thirdly, with prayer, Psalm 119, verse 18, open thou mine eyes, that I may behold wondrous things out of thy law. And sometimes we sing those words, that God would show us. Because the Bible is not just a religious book. It's not just a theological book. It is God's Word. So therefore, preparation must be in prayer. And we must come prayerfully to the Word of God. And again, even in the means of grace tonight, even in the service of worship, we come with diligence, with preparation, and with prayer. We don't haphazardly come to the service of worship this night. We don't come expecting suddenly that we will switch on to the things of God. And then our second point is how we receive the Word. It says we are to receive it with faith and love. To receive the Word of God with faith, believing, trusting in that Word, and loving that Word. With faith, Hebrews 4 verse 2, the Word preached did not profit them, speaking of the children of Israel in the wilderness, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it. Every time we hear the Word of God, we are to trust and we are to place our faith and hope in that Word. And then love, 2 Thessalonians 2:10, they received not the love of the truth that they might be saved. To love the Word of God is so important. Then our third main point, what are we to do with the Word? We are to lay it up in our hearts. Psalm 119, verse 11, thy word have I hid in mine heart, that I might not sin against thee. Literally, to memorize the Word of God. We are to memorize God's Word. It's not just to be words on a page, but it is to be words in our minds. And then lastly, how do we honor the Word? And it says, and practice it in our lives. To actually do the Word of God, to actually live it out. That's to give the greatest honor to it. James 1:25 that we've been looking at recently on the Monday night says, but whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the word, this man shall be blessed in his deed. So, how is the word to be read and heard, that it may become effectual to salvation? That the word may become effectual to salvation, we must attend thereunto with diligence, preparation, and prayer, receive it with faith and love, lay it up in our hearts, and practice it in our lives. And may God help us to do so.